Hi and welcome at IBC 2019. I'm at Blackmagic Design and we're going to take a closer look at VideoAssist, which is also very exciting.
This year's IBC coverage is brought to you by NewTek, Blackmagic Design, Signiant, and G Technology.
So Stuart, you basically decided to turn the world of camera, on-camera recorders, monitors upside down and show people how it should be done. Is that correct?
I think the great thing is that when you're starting to look at developing products, you have to look at what already exists in terms of what you've developed and how you can evolve that and how you can add additional features. I mean, one of the great things about coming to events like this, like IBC or NAB or some of the big trade events, is that you listen to a lot of feedback from what customers are doing and the experience that they can give to you to say, okay, maybe if we evolve that product in the future, how can we make it better? And I think VideoAssist is a true example of a product that was a great idea that we have now made even better and even better. At IBC, the 12G version of the VideoAssist is really a product that, you know, has captured again people's imagination, because we started to integrate some of the things that people have been asking about for a while. It's not only a field monitor now that has 12 gig SDI connection, but we've also added a brighter screen, we've also added new codecs, we've also added new recording capability, and these sorts of things are the things that are always going to make the recording process and the monitoring process more versatile. So just to kind of talk a little bit about some of those key bits. 12 months ago, we announced Blackmagic RAW, and everybody started to say, Blackmagic have got a new codec, and what are the possibilities of that codec? Because we're talking about ultimately a 12-bit RAW file that is a fraction of the size of a typical RAW file, but yet its quality seems to be exceptional, and we'd spent a huge amount of time on working on that to implement that into our own cameras. But then we started to get asked questions of, but what about other cameras? What about field recorders? What about NLE software? What about all these other things? And we realized that we had to focus on not just Blackmagic products, but we also had to look at how we could work and integrate that with other manufacturers. So one of the key features of the VideoAssist 12G is that you'll see at IBC we're demonstrating that VideoAssist on a Panasonic EVA 1 and a Canon C300. And we're actually taking raw data from that sensor and we're coming out SDI from those cameras onto the new VideoAssist and we're recording in Blackmagic RAW. So whilst we're not recording Blackmagic RAW internally within those devices, we are giving Canon and Panasonic users the capability of recording Blackmagic RAW via a VideoAssist 12G. So that's a major step forward. The other part of that too is that in terms of the screen quality, people talk about HDR, people talk about being able to use that screen in different types of environments, whether it be low light or bright light. So we've put a screen on this which is capable of 2500 nits. It's DCI 100% P3. This is high quality screen, significantly brighter than the screen that people will be familiar with before. We've also put on there as well a USB-C connection, which means that now not only can you record to SD cards, but you can also now record to a USB-C drive, which means that you're now open up the capability to record to 1 terabit and 2 terabit drives. So this is an evolution, but it is ultimately a product that has moved forward in an enormous leap.
And is there a reason why you went for like USB-C, but also SD card? It's like, it's not SSD. Like, what's the reasoning behind that?
Well, when you look at things like UHC-II, I mean, they're already delivering you relatively fast speeds. When we look at the codecs that people are working with today, one of the benefits, obviously, of Blackmagic RAW is its very low file size, which means that you're actually capable of recording, you know, raw files onto an SD card. You know, for us, what we want to try and do is we want to try and ensure that that unit stays, you know, in a small form factor and it's easily portable. But the fact that we've put that USB-C on there as well now opens up all that possibility to those USB-C drives, which means that when you're actually looking to offboard your material onto a laptop, you can unplug that USB-C drive, plug that into your laptop and get high speed transfer of those files directly from that USB-C drive. You also have the capability with a USB-C connection that the speed means that you can actually natively run it from that drive as well. So again, it's all about flexibility and options. And for us, whilst SSD is something that, you know, we have invested in the past, and the same with CFast, we just feel that with this device, there is enough options on there to deliver you the quality and the speed that most people would need.
And it's can you say low cost? I'd say it's low cost.
I guess that we like to refer to it more in terms of accessible. You know, whenever we design a product, it's more about ensuring that people get access to it at any different level. I mean, we don't want to restrict certain people's accessibility to it. And I think that we have to make sure that people understand that, you know, choices should be made around what you need that tool for, not only be determined by cost. So when you look at the two different versions, we have a 5-inch version at €725. We have a 7-inch version, which is €895. And, you know, you then making a choice based around size rather than making a choice around cost.
Now, it connects to SDI, obviously, but what else do you have on there? Because it's pretty feature-rich, right?
Sure. So when you look at the two differences between the 5-inch and the 7-inch, there's a couple of small things that need to be considered as well. And that is with the 7-inch, if I just turn it slightly to the side, what you'll see is that we actually have on there an SDI input and an SDI output, so we can actually loop that SDI if required. We've also got HDMI connection on there as well. If you look at the 5-inch version, you'd also have SDI and HDMI, but when it comes to the SDI connection, it's actually the small BNC connector, so you would need a small BNC to a large BNC connector. So another thing as well is in terms of audio connectivity. On the 7-inch version, you've got small XLR, so you've got balanced and unbalanced audio capability on there too. And then one other thing to mention as well, when we talk about the screen and the quality, it's not also just capable of delivering the images that you're shooting from the camera, but you've also got some very high quality scopes in there as well. So you're able to see HDR scopes, histogram and waveform monitor that are capable of going full screen on that unit too.
Can I load LUTs?
You can. So there is the ability to load LUTs. In the menu structure, if you go along with anyone who's familiar with the menu structure within our cameras, will also be familiar with that within the Video Assist, because they're both very similar. And there does have the ability in there to load presetted LUTs. If you're pulling them from another camera or if you're pulling them from DaVinci Resolve, very, very easy to load in.
Cheers, thanks.
No problem.
Yeah.